Hi, I'm Mallory Brooke, makeup artist and content creator here on YouTube, and today we are trying all newly released makeup, including the new Danessa Myricks Lightwork Volume 5 palette, as well as fun stuff for holiday releases from Hourglass. So let's go ahead and get into it. All right, I'm so excited. I have a basket full of new makeup, newly released makeup, and I'm so excited to try. A lot of this has been recommended by you guys, so let's see if you have good recommendations, usually you do. So right now I'm reviewing a foundation. It's what I have on my face right now. So I will have everything I mentioned, talk about, and wearing all in the info box below. And yes, they are all affiliate links if I can help it. And shopping through my links, just so you know, helps support this channel. I do make a small commission on whatever you purchase through the links. Don't have to use my links, but when you do, thank you. Straight from me to you for supporting the channel. Now, the very first thing I'm so excited to try, I have not tried anything from House Labs, but you guys have told me over and over that I have to try the new Triclone Skin Tech Concealer. So I got it and I purchased the shade 03 Fair Rosy because I like my concealer to have a bit of a pink undertone to cancel out the blue under my eyes. This concealer is $32 and it has a natural finish. It says it's hydrating, good for dark circles. Yes, that would be wonderful. I hope so. And it's also good for acne and blemishes. It's supposed to blur, brighten, and conceal. What do you know? A concealer that's supposed to do those things. Pretty great. Actually, look how cute that is. The little H there. It's got niacinamide, fermented arnica, which does help with darkness and bruises and things like that. So I'm sure it helps with under eye dark circles, and hyaluronic acid complex plumps and hydrates, niacinamide, brighten and boost skin hydration. So lots of fun stuff there. It says it de-puffs after 2 weeks of daily use. Girl, I don't wear makeup every day, but we'll see. A lot of people really love this, so we're gonna try. I think the packaging is just packaging. It's not bad, it's not great. Not like there's, you know, much to be desired in a concealer packaging, but I always like talking about packaging because I do enjoy good packaging. All right, let's see what the doe foot is like. That's what I am most curious about. Ooh, this reminds me of the Hourglass Vanish Concealer. Okay, I wanna see, and I have fine lines under my eyes, so I wanna see, you know, how this does with that. All right, recently, I have really been enjoying doing the little triangle method, so just like that. And then you like blend out from there and that's all you need. So the majority of the coverage goes right into the dark area. And I'm using a Gabby Rose concealer brush. I will also have the brushes that I use in the info box below. I've been taking time to list those because I always get questions. So they will be listed under whatever product I use them for. Be a little more helpful. Okay. Whoa, that looks really good. I wasn't expecting that. That covers, and I just put three dots on. Like this versus this, are you kidding? Okay, Stephanie, let's do it again. Just a little dots here, and then blend them out from there. And you know, this method is great once your skin starts getting a little more mature. I used to love just caking on the concealer, but I could, you know? Now I got a little bit of fine lineage. So I'm all about these little tricks to get the same amount of coverage just with less product, which is actually helpful for everybody because then you're not using as much product, so you're saving money. And if you're getting the same effect using less product, why the heck not? Yeah, I really like that method. It's becoming pretty favorable. This concealer looks like skin. Now I do have a foundation on underneath it, but this looks like skin. Okay. That's really nice looking. Now, I purchased the Hourglass, finishing powder and in diffused light, which is right here. And then in the center, we have the blush, which is just rose. And then we have the metallic strobe powder and opal. And then down here, we have the bronzer, blush in diffused heat, and then the finishing powder in ethereal light. Let's go ahead and swatch because I wanna see which powder I want to use to set. Now that is diffused light. I believe that's one of the ones that I purchased a while back. Here is the blush. And then here is opal strobe light. Ooh, That's pretty. My favorite palette outside was the Jaguar one, but just didn't have the shades that I wanted. And then here's the bottom row. Top row, bottom row. I mean, they're very, you know, finely milled powders, so you're not gonna get like crazy finger swatches or anything. See on the hand though. Yeah, it doesn't really look like much. And then here is the bottom. Again, it doesn't look like much. So let's see what this looks like on the face. I'm gonna use the finishing powder in Ethereal Light because it's a little bit lighter, and I'm gonna set my under eyes with that. And I'm going to use the Gabby Rose Pro 02 to set. So I'm gonna go into Ethereal Light here. I almost got one of these palettes last holiday season, but didn't. Just because I, like I said, when these powders were released, like back in the day, God, over 10 years ago, I just wasn't that impressed with them. But like I said, I was in my 20s, so maybe just like, I don't know, my skin was already like pretty decent. So I didn't need like a crazy amazing setting powder. And I'm just setting underneath my eyes and the tops of my eyelids because I'm doing a foundation review, like I said. And I'm just blending out what's creasing underneath my eye, lower lash line. Okay, that looks like a nice setting powder. Nothing bad to say, nothing incredible. I didn't realize how small these were. I guess I don't remember because last year I went in store and I was like, eh, I don't need it. But we're gonna blush, bronze, highlight everything with this palette so we can see if it's worth it. I do like the jellyfish though, obviously. No, wrong arm. All right, you guys. Today we are trying out the new Danessa Myricks Lightwork Volume 5 palette. It is all shimmer and duochrome and all these beautiful shimmer shades. Nothing is matte in here, and I think that that's really cool because I love having all matte palettes, and then when you have something like this, you can just bring two out and then that's it. You know, you don't need to grab a bunch of different palettes to achieve different looks. But what I'm loving about the looks that I've seen Danessa create recently is that they're all shimmer. So I'm gonna create an all shimmer eye look today, and I'm gonna go ahead and, you know, dive into some greens because I haven't really truly created a green look yet. So I think what I'm gonna do is go ahead, take Evolving. This says soft energy, bold energy, grounding energy. So all of these are to, you know, ground the look, and then you have the lighter shades, things like that. So I'm gonna go into the shade Evolving, which is this beautiful green. But I'm gonna take that on first with a MAC 213 because these do, according to what I've seen Danessa do, apply beautifully with a brush. Still, if you guys can see that. So I'm going to start and I'm gonna apply this to the inner part of my eyelid. Oh my gosh, that's so pretty. Now, if you don't like shimmer and glitter, you're not gonna like this palette, that's for sure. Oh wow, look at that. Oh my gosh. I'll tell you what, I'm not a big like bold color makeup type of gal, but if it's like bold shimmer and like glossy duochrome, triochrome, quadruple times 10 chrome, I am all about those types of looks, even if there's color involved. So that's what it's like applied with a brush, which is insane because most times when companies create or brands create these type of eyeshadows, if they're not applied with a finger, you don't really get too much bang for your buck, but that's incredible. I'm just gonna go over it with my finger to make it a little stronger, just to see. Best part about this type of palette is you get to play, and because it's so bold, it really kind of hides mistakes, you know what I mean? Look at that, that's so pretty when added with a little bit with the finger. Really helps to kind of smash those pigments and really make them shine. So that is applied with a finger. So what you can do is apply these shadows, lay down the shadows with a brush so you know where you want to put them, and then go over with your finger once they're mapped out. That is kind of mind-blowing. That with like mascara could be it. But I want to go into the shade Fearless here because it has a green shift to it, but it's also kind of warm and pink. Look at that. So let's apply this just with the finger and see. Oh my God. Okay, okay, okay. So this eyeshadow palette is $135. And I was like, golly, what I do for a living is expensive, and it is. But when something turns out to be this beautiful, it makes it worth it. Oh my God. Do you guys see this almost looks fake. I am like, okay. All of a sudden, my nausea is going away because this is so pretty. Wow. I thought Danessa was kind of closing 2023 with the Groundwork palette, which I love. But here we are. She's popping this out too. And this does not look like something she just like thought of real quick and released for the holidays because it's shimmery. This took a lot of thought and formulating. Wow. Okay, so since that's blowing my mind, I feel like we need the darker green over here. So I'm gonna go. Even my fingers are looking fun. Oh, I'm feeling so much better now. I'm gonna go into the shade Abundant. Excuse me? That looks like a June bug. Like, legit. I'm gonna go in with my finger since we've already got it on here, but I'm gonna take my finger sideways and press. Do you guys see how crazy blended that looks already? I mean, I know I'm talented, but girl, this has something to do with the formula. Okay, I just created a smoky eye look, and if I wasn't filming, I would be done. Apply some mascara and go, and I haven't even touched an eyeshadow blending brush. So sideways. And I'm just applying this like I would if I were applying it with a brush. Oh, wow. This is crazy. Then the more you press and blend with your finger, the higher the shine. Really activates those shimmers. Oh my God. Okay. Do you see that shift? I'm like, I don't understand how that's possible. Are my eyes gonna explode? Like, is this... I just need to clean this up real quick here. All right. That's stunning. I feel like we need to go now, maybe bring in some other shades we haven't used yet and apply those, like three different here. Ooh, you know what we should do? We'll do Unstoppable towards the outer part of the eye. We'll do Fierce in the center and then Radiant towards the inner corner. Yeah, okay, I like that. I need a dense brush. I'm gonna use a BK Beauty 204 smudger brush and I'm gonna go right into Unstoppable, which let's swatch. Oh, that's beautiful. That's got like a purple, green, gold shift. It reminds me of Max Club back in the day, the duochromes. Okay, I'm gonna smudge this and connect it. Oh, that's so pretty. This palette is insanely gorgeous. Now I'm just gonna take a BK Beauty 203, put a little bit of Unstoppable on it, get off on my wrist here, kind of smash those pigments and blend. Oh my God, this is so pretty. Now I'm just gonna blend the outer edge upward and outward. This shift, when I turn my head, keeps just like blowing my mind. All right, next for the center of the eye, there is like a nice kind of peachy orange shift in this center shade, which one is it? Fearless. So I feel like Fierce will really complement it right in the middle. But I'm gonna apply this with my finger. Wow, wowzas. Okay, that's insane. I'm gonna go ahead and take a BK Beauty 203 that has a little bit of Fierce on it, and I'm gonna blend that out. Kind of keeping it in the center, but still blending it out a little bit. Do you got, it's like I just put my finger into 8 different eyeshadows. I mean, this is insane. Have you guys picked this palette up? I know it's like such a treat. And I'll say this, like if I didn't do this for a living, I would have waited and purchased this during the Sephora sale, which this palette honestly is probably gonna be in my recommendations now that I'm thinking about it. I've already made a list of recommendations and I wanted to go through a few more products before I film it. But I think this is definitely gonna be an addition because I'm thoroughly like blown away. Now for the very center of the lower lash line, and I'm gonna go ahead and bring this shade up a little bit through the corner. I'm gonna take the shade Radiant. I feel like it's very complementary because do you see this green shift? And it's warm, like Fierce and Fearless. Okay, so I'm just gonna tilt my head back, and actually, I'm gonna go from this direction here. No, okay, we need the other finger. All right, there we go. Take that smudger brush, cleaned it off. I'm gonna take Radiant, and I'm gonna go right here into the inner corner and pull that up with that same smudger brush right over where I applied a little bit with my finger. Whew. Do the same thing on the other side. Wow. Oh my God. Whoa. Do you guys see this shift? I am so blown away. So blown away. Radiant really brought everything together, I feel. Okay. I am gonna stop there. I'm going to take a clean blending brush and just blend the inner corner. And this is a Sigma diffused crease brush. There we go. Oh my God, that's 6 eyeshadows. And it still doesn't look like too much, in my opinion. That's stunning. Now for my waterline, I don't have a new eyeliner, but this is new-ish. This is the Hourglass Waterproof Gel Liner in Chestnut. And it's a really nice warm brown, and I think it'll go well in the waterline with this entire look. Really keep the interesting aspects of this look there, as well as the warmth. I'm gonna take that BK Beauty 204 that we've been smudging with and just smudge this liner out on the lower part of the eye. I'm not winging this out. Now I'm going to apply my mascara, pop on a corner lash. I feel like that'll really complete the lift without using any liner, because I don't want to use liner because I don't want to take away from the shift of this. All right, now we have our corner lashes on. I just used Rare Beauty's Perfect Strokes mascara. Love this mascara for volume. And I feel like with this type of look, we need a lot of volume so the lashes can stick out. Corner lashes I created with Lily Lashes Brown Blended in the Buff. Now we're moving on to, and I'm keeping this on, this palette, the new Hourglass Ambient Lighting Edit Unlocked palette is $90, but the Jellyfish one, from what I could see and read, has the most new shades. So Rose Fusion is a new shade. Then we have Opal Strobe Light, which is a new shade, and Lunar Bronze, which is a new shade. So very excited about that. And I am going to go ahead and use Lunar Bronze and bronze up my face with this. Where's my, yeah, I'm gonna use the Jones Road bronzer brush. It's just kind of like a nice little flat, dense brush there. And this is a small pan. I swear I don't remember these being that small. I'm gonna actually start by taking this bronzer across the bridge of my nose and across my forehead. I want the bronze to be in the natural places I would normally bronze, which is on my cheeks, nose, across my forehead. And since this foundation that I'm testing out is a little light for me, I feel like we can bronze up a little bit. And I've really been liking a center bronze lately. I think it deflects from my dark circles and everything we have going on there. I'm a little sunken in. Now, let's see. I think that that's a really nice shade. And the reason why I went with the Jellyfish is because it has more new shades. And also the coloring is a little bit more like yellow, warm undertoned rather than the Leopard palette. It's a little more rosy pinky. And then the Snake is like too dark for me. So I feel like the Jellyfish might be where it's at. And honestly, that's really nice. I think I might be someone who would enjoy the ambient lighting powders now that I am in my 30s. I think I can appreciate the nice, like, diffused look it's giving me. So I actually have fine lines now to diffuse. All right, for blush, I'm gonna use the new shade that's in here, which is Rose Fusion. And I'm gonna take that on an Angie Hot and Flashy A507. It's a nice little angled brush that's kind of, it's not dense, so we can have a lot of diffusion going on, so we can blend after we apply. And I'm gonna apply this at the center of my face, just because, like I said, lately I've just really been liking the pigmentation being in the center of my face. I'm gonna take that along my forehead as well, just whatever's left. And I'm gonna start pressing upward to kind of drape a little bit, but not moving the pigment around too much, keeping it in the center. A little bit more of a youthful situation there. That's really pretty. I can't believe I'm a little bit blown away by these powders. And last year in the vlog, I was like, you guys, these powders are not, I swatched them in store and you guys were like, but you didn't, you gotta try them on your face. I was like, eh, yeah, sure, whatever. These are pretty. Now I'm gonna go into the new Opal Strobe Light. And I'm gonna use that as a highlight. And I'm gonna take that on the same Angie Hot and Flashy A507. And I'm going to start at the top there and sweep outward. Oh, that's really nice. Okay. Also, the Unlocked thing with Hourglass, they donate 5% of annual profits from this collection to the Non-Human Rights Project. So not only are you looking good, you're doing good. Hourglass should hire me for that one. All right, the Opal Strobe Light is a little pink. I thought it'd be more champagne of a highlight, so that's kind of ew on for me. I don't know, actually that looks kind of nice. Oh, that's really pretty. Okay, so I'm gonna take that on the top as well, right near my nose. Bring that out, bring in the center of my forehead, my nose, chin. And then I'm gonna go back into Rose Fusion and just kind of build that up on the center of my cheeks, right over the highlight again. These powders are so nice and lightweight that you can really layer. Oh girl, I'm going crazy. I'm gonna bring a little bit of the bronze higher up into my hairline. Beautiful, the Jellyfish palette is beautiful. Now I'm going to take a BK Beauty 105 and just blend all of this together. Just like your eyeshadows need blended, your face products need blended. Okay, I'm liking this. Also, quick halfway through the makeup, kind of like fully through the makeup, report on the concealer, it's good. Okay, I think I can officially take this off because I really like this palette. I wish the highlight might have been a little more golden, but it looks really good with the shades that are in this one in particular. All right, I like that. All right, you guys, now let's try some new lip products. Now, I saw, and I was so curious, I had to purchase the same shade. Now, let's get into this. Okay, one of my favorite NARS Velvet Matte Lip Pencils is the shade Take Me Home. Well, I saw that NARS released their new Power Matte High Intensity Lip Pencil, and it's in the same shade Take Me Home. So I wanna see, look at that. Okay, oh, it's smaller. Do you get the same amount of product? 0.08 ounces and 0.08 ounces. It's just a smaller packaging deal. All right, I'll swatch both Take Me Homes and we can see if they are the same. So here is the Velvet Matte formula in Take Me Home. I think it's just such a pretty warm kind of nude rose. And then here is the, oh, they are different. Different. Power Matte, which actually looks kind of glossy. So the new Power Matte is on the top and the Velvet is on the bottom. There is a sheen to it, so it may look a little lighter, but it looks a little bit more like a more of a vibrant shade than the original Take Me Home. Let me know what your thoughts are below. Which one do you prefer? I love the original Take Me Home. I also purchased a lip liner, which is one of the new Anastasia Beverly Hills lip liner shades in Deep Taupe. Let's swatch this next to it. I don't know if it'll be a good, ooh, I think that will be a good kind of grounding shade for this. I love the Anastasia Beverly Hills lip liners. So let's just see if we like this shade. Yes, we do. These are just so creamy and easy to apply. All right, I think Deep Taupe is definitely a winner. I thought it would have a little more warmth in it. So let's see. Okay, look at that. Look, the Power Matte definitely mattified. By the time it took me to do my lip liner, it's definitely pinkier than the original Take Me Home. Let's see if we like it. Oh yeah, I like it. So this is supposed to last longer than the Velvet Mattes. I thought that they were like doing away with them, but no, this is just an addition to the line. All right, very nice combo. It goes on really smooth and my lips are super dry right now. So that's really great. I'm just going back in with Deep Taupe to ground it again. Yeah, okay, I think that is a really pretty lip combo. Again, original Take Me Home, new Take Me Home, Deep Taupe, right? Yeah, Deep Taupe. That's a good combo. That is a good combo. Let's take my bangs out of the clips. All right, you guys, this is my full face of newly released makeup. A lot of this is for the holidays, like the Hourglass ambient powder palettes and all of that stuff. So let me know what your favorite item that I used so far is. This concealer. Okay, before we get ahead of ourselves, let's wrap this up with my first impression thoughts on everything that I purchased. Starting with the House Labs Triclone Concealer, Skin Tech Concealer. I purchased the shade 03 Fair. I have to say this, I love the paddle. I feel like there were no corners cut when it came to the actual applicator. And this is something that I wish that other brands would do. I really like a nice luxurious applicator when it comes to concealer. The really flimsy ones sometimes can hurt and be a little sharp and stabby. I have to say this, upon first impressions, I feel like my under eyes look smoother than they have in a very long time. I set with the ambient powder, the Hourglass Ambient Powder. That is such a pretty duo. Wow, I'm kind of blown away because my under eyes have looked so sunken in and so just kind of parched. Recently, I went back on low-dose chemo for neurological Behçet's disease, so everything's kind of sinking in and getting a little dry, a little wrinkly, crinkly, and I feel like this is really kind of hiding that. Very impressed with this concealer. You guys are gonna have to let me know your thoughts on this. I will keep trying it out. If my opinions change, I will let you know. But let me just say this, upon first impressions and the way it's looking on my skin, under my eyes right now, I prefer this to the By Mario Surreal Skin Concealer, which I just purchased recently a couple of months ago, and I love. This is beautiful. All right, next, the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Edit Unlocked Jellyfish Palette. I think it went beautifully together. I think that this setting powder, the finishing powder in Ethereal Light, really did justice to my under eyes. I feel bright, I feel set, but I feel like my concealer after this entire time is not creasing or looking wrinkly and crinkly. I absolutely love the bronzer and the blush and the highlight. I feel like it all came together beautifully. I feel like this is definitely curated well. Let me know what Hourglass Ambient Unlocked palette you are looking at. I like the jellyfish itself and I like the shades in here. Again, I do wish that the highlight was a little less, had a little less pink shift, but with everything else in the palette, it looks beautiful. All right. This blew me away. The Danessa Myricks Lightwork Volume 5 I Am Palette. I like the positive vibes, the energy. I could have done this entire eye look without any eyeshadow brushes, which blows me away. And each eyeshadow is really standing its own. The shift on these are incredible. I think that this is one of the most beautiful palettes I have ever used. It is pricey, so keep it on, you know, unless you just cannot wait, keep it on the back burner for the sale. Get your 20% off, 15% off, 10% off, whatever you might be level wise, but I believe this is like already sold out. I'm not quite sure. Again, I'll have everything linked below that I used in order of use. If you're interested, I love the packaging. I think it's so beautiful. It reminds me of a seashell, which I'm definitely partial to the sea. Really love this. I think it's unique and we used all different shades and it all went beautifully together. All right, the lip combo. Really like the Anastasia Beverly Hills lip liner in Deep Taupe. I feel like if you took Strip Down and deepened it one shade, I think that that would be probably about where this lip liner is looking to me. And then we have the new NARS Power Matte High Intensity Lip Pencil. Love the way it feels so far on my lips. I've only had it on my lips for a few minutes, but it's comfortable, which a lot of reviews said that it was, and it is. Take Me Home is definitely different than the Satin Lip Pencil, so keep that in mind. It's a little bit deeper and a little bit pinkier, but there's still enough warmth in there to be really beautiful, in my opinion. Now, if you like pinkier lips, then go for something pinkier, but this formula is really nice. Also, no transfer. So those are all of the new products that I recently purchased. Let me know if you've tried any of them. Let me know what you have your eye on for the sale. I'm so curious. Coming will be my wish list, recommendations, and then eventually my haul. My wish list is that of a queen's, let me tell you. Thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know if you enjoy me trying new products by giving this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. We would love to have you in this beautiful, wonderful, positive community. And I will see you guys in the next one. Until then, I'm gonna be doing this in the mirror. All right.